Hey everyone, today I'm going to talk to you about an exciting event coming up in October at the DevLearn conference. I'm going to walk you through what my plans are for the xAPI Accelerator. So let's go ahead and get started. Is Jeff Batt, and if you haven't checked out my website, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all of my weekly blogs covering different learning development topics. You can also download free templates and Articulate Storyline 360, xAPI, and video templates as well. And then if any of these topics are new to you, you can check out full courses covering everything from A to Z in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm, and HTML5 Video. Now you may ask yourself, okay, how does this actually differ from your xAPI Fundamentals course? I wanted to walk you through those questions and some of the reasons why you'd want to come to this hands-on experience, this two-day experience, and what you can expect to get out of it as well. So if you go to devlearn.com, DevLearn is an awesome conference for any learning developments, instructional designer, anything like that. I've been going for years. It is a highlight of the year, and it is something that you don't want to miss. So to get to the xAPI Accelerator, just go under Program, go under Pre-Conference Activities here, and then go to the two-day certificate programs here. The second choice right here, xAPI Accelerator, is the one that I'm going to be talking about today. It is going to be held on Sunday and Monday of October 22nd. Through the 23rd, so 2 days, you're coming in a little bit early. The conference itself doesn't start until the 25th, so again, you're coming in a little bit early. You could even just come to this event, you can come to the full events. There is a lot that you'll want to check out at DevLearn here. So let's walk through kind of the outline of what to expect at this xAPI Accelerator course. And I really split it up into four different sections here, and I'm showing my Trello board because this is kind of my mastermind outline of what the day should look like here. And this could change. I'm constantly going in and improving it, looking at hands-on workshop kinds of things that we could do. So a lot of that here. So you'll notice, first of all, the labels of instruction, that's really where I'm just giving you a lot of information, kind of an outline. And then you'll notice a lot of hands-on work. This 2 day is going to get you started everything from A to Z inside of xAPI. If you have no clue what xAPI is, but you want to know, this is the session for you. This is what you'll need to know in order to get started. That's really why it's called Accelerator, because it's going to take you from 0 to 60 working with xAPI. So you can go back to your organization and you could start implementing some of the things, the strategies, the tools that we're going to be talking about, some of the templates as well. You can go in and start implementing that right away. You can see here we have the instruction, but also hands-on work as well. So that's kind of a combination of the both. Let's take it kind of section by section. So the first day, day one, morning of that section, we're going to just talk about some of the SCORM limitations. We're going to talk about xAPI, why xAPI. We're going to talk about understanding events, learning record store and statements. We're going to dive into what the statement is. There's really three parts of an xAPI statement. We're going to talk about all of that so you understand, okay, what is an actor? What is a verb? What is an object? Which is very important when you're working with xAPI. We're going to talk about something that I get so excited about with xAPI, the ability to personalize content and how you could track content from one course and then use that content, what they've done in that previous course, in a future course as well, in order to personalize and adapt content. Also, designing for adaptive content. We're going to talk about what xAPI profiles are, if you've heard of profiles, what they are, how to start using them, and when we start talking about strategy and so forth, how you can start to find the right profiles for you. And then we're going to use an xAPI strategy document. So at the end of this morning, we've already covered a lot, but you're going to get into a strategy document that will help you out with planning for your next organization. So one of the key benefits of doing this in person is you get experience from other people and what they have done, but also you get hands-on experience working with me as you start to implement these things, as you start to work with these different templates and so forth. And so really it's more engaging than what you would do inside of online. Part two, now we're setting up a learning record store already. And this is just day one in the morning. We're starting to set up a learning record store. And then we're starting to explore the different files. We're going to publish to xAPI. We're going to publish to CMI5 and talk about what CMI5 is. We're going to connect to an external learning record store. All of that by the time you even hit lunch on day one. So it's just a lot of content kind of packed in. Now, I do kind of feather out a little bit in day two what we'll cover in case we need to push it, because sometimes we want to spend a little bit more time. People have questions on different things. And so even though I kind of front load the beginning, I then am able to kind of stretch it out and adapt the content based on the audience needs there. All right, so day one in the afternoon, after lunch, after we got some energy, then we can go in and talk about what the JSON format is. We'll talk about adding custom triggers inside of Storyline and Captivates, how you would do that inside of Captivate. We'll start to publish, we'll test out question data, we'll start to add some custom variables to some of these statements, we'll publish out to an external learning record store. We'll cover a little bit of what Lectora does with xAPI Smart Builder as well. And then finally, to wrap up day one, we're going to be connecting all of our data to a learning record store. We'll kind of high level cover how you can use Watershed and Veracity. I can't cover every learning record store, so these are just ones that I've worked with a lot. So we're going to talk about how to set up reports and how to set up different things and get your data into these different learning record stores. So that is day one. That is a lot. Again, if we need to push some stuff back into day two, we'll do that. But coming into day two, we're now going to start talking about evaluating tools, how you evaluate authoring tools as well as evaluate learning record stores when you're looking at these different things, and some of the reasons why you'd want to choose this over that as well. So it's just kind of this strategy evaluation part. Depending on the audience, we will cover a little bit of JavaScript basics, because when you're working with xAPI, it is very flexible. You can use JavaScript to send custom statements as well. So we'll cover a little bit of that. I mean, I just may hand you some JavaScript code and explain what it is, and I'm trying to make it as easy as possible. But then we're going to go into different templates as well. We'll write a custom JavaScript where you can just copy and paste it in. You don't have to, if you don't want to code, I'll just give you the snippets. You can just copy and paste it in. But then we will talk about that. We will also work with different templates for day two, and then PDF wrappers, YouTube wrappers as well. And then finally, we'll talk about Zapier, being able to connect applications that you want to track that aren't normal course authoring tools, and how you could track those inside of a learning record store using a tool called Zapier to make those connections. That really is the outline. This is still a work in progress. I may add stuff, I may condense stuff, I may make it a little bit easier with all the snippets. So it's a work in progress, but you can see that we already have a lot planned. So really, you're gonna, at the end of this session, be able to send xAPI statements. You're going to be able to connect to the learning record store. You're going to be able to run reports inside of the learning record store. You're going to be able to have a strategy document and templates and a lot of this stuff that you can then go back to your organization, hit the ground running, and really start using xAPI inside of your organization. Not only that, I'm going to give you access to a lot of different resources and things that you can take home to help you. It is a two-day packed event. I hope to see you there. I'm going to give you a lot of resources, and you're really going to go from 0 to 60 with xAPI. So if you want to learn about xAPI, you want to join me, go ahead and head on over to DevLearn and make sure that you register for the pre-conference events of xAPI Accelerator. That's all I have for today. If you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel and click that like button and subscribe to my channel, as well as hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows me to continue to produce these videos for you. And if you have any questions, type in those questions below the video as well. I check the questions every single week. Again, that's all I have. So thanks everyone. I'll see you next time.